So the kind of living environment that you see today, with the physical distancing, sitting far away, not meeting, it's not usual to all of us, and probably we all have to adjust to it. It will be challenging for TVET colleges more than even universities. Why? Because TVET colleges courses are very practical courses. You cannot reach it online or remotely. Even if you will put systems together, it's not going to happen. Universities will be able to, somewhere. Better. Not through all courses. I don't think as a doctor I can learn through online, ever. So they have to make provisions for students to come. But teachers have to have no other choice than to put those provisions more rigorously. Because your online classes is the only way of, or the most preferred way of giving practical learning to student community. Now, how do you survive or live for the next 2 to 3 years with such a disease that not only spreads through the surface, but is also now airborne? Means the droplets spread very quickly from one human to the other. But you must also remember that with this virus, that 80% of our population, which is young people, will remain asymptomatic. Even if they will have the virus, they will not have any symptoms, or they will have a very mild symptom. The question is, as soon as a mild symptom comes, and that's why when you see the health check and when you do it every day, you see they have the same questions, and then you get bored that they are the same questions. But those are early symptoms. A single sign that one gets not get a clearance should immediately isolate. Because if you isolate at that time, you will not only spread the virus, but even if you were in touch with anybody positive, you will also, if you are living in any comorbid, your chances of getting the virus will also be minimal. So my important thing is, when I was looking at the presentation, both the presentations on preparation, my first request is when you enter the gate, when we entered it, the driver gave us that thing to fill. You can't do that now. It's transmission of the virus from one human to the other. When you printed these papers for, which is a gesture for our honorable minister and myself to be here in this organization, for the regional manager who's come all the way to your campus. But now, probably the paper when you give from one hand to the other, there's a high chance that the virus moves very quickly. So project it on the screen, the agenda. And paper-to-paper transmission to minimize. If you have this phone, like I did my daily screening this morning, and I got my clearance, I can show it from my car to the gate, and you can do the temperature screening. That's fine. And I can show the clearance, enter the date, and the time with your name. The security should not need to fill your details through you. Either he has to fill it himself, asking you questions, because the aim is to not, simple thing is to not allow the virus to move from one hand to the other, and it moves slightly quicker. So all we need to do is we need not to be worried about this virus. This virus is not going to kill us. The best part is we prevent the virus from spreading. And if we as social solidarity takes a principal decision, we will not be paper hand to hand. We will maintain, like the way you are doing them very well. Same screen, you just put a sanitizer. With just a simple sanitizer, the virus dies. That's how quickly the virus dies. So science can tell that if we can kill this virus so quickly, then why is this virus causing havoc? It's because of the social behavior of human behavior. So all I'm trying to say is keep it simple. I saw in your report that you